Hey, hello gamers, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. I'm VK, and in this video, we're going to be talking about something a little bit more old school by now, at least. At least now it is old school. It wasn't always old school, but it's old school now, and that's how that works. And we're going to be talking about variants, mainly only from Advanced Warfare, because that's really where they counted and where they actually were a thing. So those are the ones we're going to be talking about. And I would actually like to propose an idea. I'd like to propose a thought, right? Food for thought, right? And I'd like to raise the conversation of what if they brought variants back, and should they bring variants back? Because I actually rather enjoyed the variants. The only thing that I didn't really enjoy about these variants were the fact that they were hided behind supply drops. Now, if they could make a system where you can actually unlock these using credits, right, and preferably not obviously paid credits, because that would be pay to win, but just in general grindable credits, like armory credits or such were in World War II, then I would love that. I would absolutely love that to bits. Because just in general, the variants, they add a lot more content to the game, and not to mention, like, if they would bring out camos for these variants just as much as they are for the normal guns, that could actually add a lot more interesting content that we don't already have, let's be honest there, right? I find Black Ops 4 to be quite lackluster in content, and I know some people are going to say, well, it has more content than other CODs, and hey, that might be fair, but you also have to consider that this Call of Duty isn't everybody's favorite, and I feel like there can be improvements made, and there can be strides to keep people playing this game, even after come November, when the new Call of Duty releases, regardless of what COD it is. I mean, they should really, they said they wanted to support Black Ops 4, and I feel like that could be definitely a good way for them to do that. And it doesn't have to be with variants, I'm not saying that. They can do multiple things, they can just steadily keep adding content. But I do feel like the amount of content hasn't exactly been crazy so far. Oh, I'm gonna pull back here. It's been okay, but it's been nothing special. And for a game that they plan to support for a long time, like they said, I don't really feel that. I don't get the feeling of, hey, this is something special to us. This is something we want to do for a long time. Not really getting that feeling with this game. But that said, I do like this game. So I don't feel like it has to have variants or something like that. But it would be interesting just to see the question raised. Like, are they willing to do that? Are we willing to receive it, right? Like, it's not because I want it that you guys might want it. And, maybe not for this Call of Duty, obviously, I get that. Maybe that's too late to put it in now, even though they could just add a couple of them in via a special event or something. But maybe for the next Call of Duty, that could be an interesting idea, right? Like, you would have to grind for those variants, and you could actually unlock them using your own credits. And the way you would get those credits is by playing the game. And you would actually have to choose which ones you got, because obviously there would be multiple variants then. And you would actually have to learn the game, so it's like, it's just the same like as in Advanced Warfare. You would have certain ones that obviously are suited for the majority of the playstyles, others are suited for specific playstyles. And you would obviously have a couple that are, well, quite overpowered, let's be honest, because you have the ASMR 1 Speakeasy in Advanced Warfare. But, I mean, it's not exactly like this game is without its overpowered weapons. I mean, definitely not. Like, it has some crazy patazy stuff in there. So I don't really feel like it's out of the question, if you know what I'm saying. Like, I don't really get that feels. Oh, let's get out of here. Damn it. Alright, let's get back in there. Okay. Definitely. That's my boy! Keep me alive! Okay. He knows I'm here. I have a microphone in my face, for the record. My microphone is very much forward. Oh, I died. I was so close to my strike team. Well, that's a shame, isn't it? But yeah, that's really the main question that I wanted to bring up. Like, are you guys open to receiving variants? And even in general, like, would that be the way for you to want to receive them? Like, is there a different way that maybe you would think about variants being in the game? Like, would they only have to be cosmetic variants? Because I feel like stat variants are kind of, they're very cool to me. Like, not to mention, like, cosmetic variants are cool and all, But it's the ones that are pretty stat-changing in, for example, World War II that really made it for me. Like, cosmetic variants are cool, like in World War II we had a couple of that and stuff. But it's really when the stat-changing stuff comes in, like, I feel like I'm playing a game that can actually have years of life. And I know that Advanced Warfare did not, but obviously it wasn't a very liked game by the entire scope of the community. And I feel like if a game that is actually liked by the large scope of the community, and it has that, brings that in, then it could definitely be played for years to come. And I genuinely do not understand how people can still play Black Ops 2 to this day. It's my favorite Call of Duty out of all of them. But I couldn't play anything like that for that amount of time for so long. Like, there's people that have been non-stop grinding Black Ops 2 since the freaking start. And that is mental to me. Like, those people, they've got to be a little bit insane at this point, right? Nuketown must be bleeding out of their eyes, if you know what I'm saying. But, if you like it, that's kind of cool, but we need a game that's going to draw us out of that cycle. We need a game that's able to sustain us for the next 5 years to come or something. And I really believe that if they come out with a boots on the ground game that has variants properly introduced, then that could be it. But yeah, leave your two cents on that topic down in the comments down below, because I'd actually love to know. Personally, I would love to see them again, be it in a non-luck-based, non-pay-to-win variant. But anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like on it. If you want to see more about it, hit that subscribe button and that notification bell, because I like bells. Ding! This has been VK, and we'll see you next video. Bye!